Good morning, everyone. I am Thomas Marissal. I am research chair at the Mediterranean Institute of Neurobiology in Marseille. And I hope you will be indulgent with me because it's the first time I pre-record a talk. And I am never happy of myself. So it's like the 12th time I am recording myself. And my voice tend to be more and more robotic this time. But I will not see your reaction as I will be sleeping where you will see my face. Anyways, let me share my screen. Up. Et voilà. Before starting, I would like to warmly thank my friend Nathalie Deorter, as well as the other organizers of that Australasian Developmental Neuroscience Symposium for having given me the opportunity to say a few words about those parabimilitary neurons and their pathological role on neurodevelopmental disorders. Several syndromes such as schizophrenia, autism spectrum disorders, but also attention deficit, hyperactivity disorders, and intellectual disability, which are typically present during childhood, are grouped together as neurodevelopmental disorders. And they can be caused by a huge variety of genes, of environmental factors, or nature-nurture interplay. And despite that heterogeneity of causal factors, an iconoclastic view is that neurodevelopmental disorders, rather than being etiologically discrete entities, could be conceived as an etiological continuum. And according to this model, similar kinds of neurodevelopmental alteration, but occurring with different timing and different severity, may lead to several different functional outcomes and phenotypic expression. And accordingly, the brain from the patients or from reliable mouse models related to neurodevelopmental disorders exhibit comparable alteration of the neural network dynamics. More specifically, behavior-related local neural oscillations, such as the theta or gamma rhythm, are often found impaired in brain regions that are thought to play a key role in these pathologies, such as the hippocampus or the prefrontal cortex. Moreover, the coupling between those two regions, two functionally connected regions, which is reflected by the oscillation LFP coherence, or by the phase locking of cells from one region to oscillation of the other regions, are often altered too. At a microscale level, alteration in the structural and the synaptic plasticity and unbalanced excitatory inhibitory equilibrium are commonly associated with neurodevelopmental diseases. As for the synaptic and the circuit levels, is there a component at the cellular level that could make a common link between the microscale alteration and the macroscale alteration that are associated with the neurodevelopmental disorder continuum? And parvalbumin interneurons could be that missing link because they are major contributors to the cortical inhibition. They modulate the plasticity, and they orchestrate oscillations. In an attempt to demonstrate the key role of those parvalbumin interneurons, several groups have manipulated their properties. By selectively deleting NMDA glutamatergic receptor, which this function is traditionally associated with schizophrenia and autism, or by selectively deleting ERBB4 receptors with gene, as well as the gene encoding for its ligand NRG1 or schizophrenia susceptibility genes, or by selectively perturbating oxidative stress regulation, by selectively depleting parvalbumin expression, or by chemosynthetically inhibiting parvalbumin interneuron activity. Those manipulations lead to alteration in learning and memory, in social interaction, alteration gating, emotional behavior, and or cognitive function. In short, The results suggest that the alteration of PV function is sufficient to induce phenotypes that are reminiscent of neurodevelopmental diseases such as schizophrenia or autism. However, it remained unclear until very recently whether PVI properties were altered or not in reliable models of neurodevelopmental disease and if they could be the target for innovative therapeutical approach. So let us focus on a few research articles that recently brought some answers. During my postdoc in Geneva, Switzerland, I have studied the hippocampus from LGDL mice that replicate the chromosomal alteration of the human 22q11 deletion syndrome, which is the highest genetic risk factor for developing schizophrenia. It's also associated with anxiety, with learning deficit, and a lot of other. And I have monitored the hippocampal neuronal activity in vitro using GCAM6-based calcium imaging in conditions where the wild-type network in black, TA1, generate oscillatory activity which are similar to those which are recorded in vivo during a behavior. The activity level, which are reflected by the number of active cells, as well as the frequency, the amplitude, and the duration of calcium transient was not significantly different between the wild type in black and the LGDL neurons in red. In contrast, LGDL display fewer neurons that are coactive above chance level and fewer occurrence of this coactivation. In summary, LGDL slices exhibit the same level of activity, but a desynchronization of the network. To gain further insight into the mechanism underlying altered CA1 dynamics, we record spontaneous excitatory and inhibitory currents in pyramidal cells. And we observe that CA1 pyramids from LGDL mice had a comparable number of spontaneous excitatory inputs, but fewer inhibitory inputs per second compared to the wild type, which is reflected by an increased value of inhibitory input inter-event interval. Those results provide evidence that hippocampal pyramid and LGDL mice are characterized by hypoinhibition, which likely originates from the alteration of the firing activity of GABAergic neurons. So we further test the role of PV interneurons in the hypoinhibition of pyramidal neurons by recording genetically labeled PVIs. And current clamp experiments revealed that CA1 PVIs were less excitable in LGDL than in wild-type animals. That firing difference disappeared when GABAergic and glutamatergic receptors were blocked pharmacology. Thus, PVI hypoexcitability may rather reflect difference in PVI synaptic input than change in intrinsic properties. And supporting this hypothesis, CA1 PVI neurons recorded from LGDL mice receive similar number of spontaneous excitatory neurons, but more spontaneous inhibitory input, which is reflected by a decreased value of inhibitory input intervent interval. So taken together, all data indicated that CA1 pyramidal cells are hypoinhibited, which is caused by the hypoexcitability of PVI interneurons. Now, could hippocampal network dynamics be rescued in LGDL mice by increasing PV interneuron excitability? To answer this question, we first use pharmacological approach by using neuroregulin 1 peptide or NRG1P in blue. Or second, we specifically express the excitatory DREAD receptor in CA1 neurons, which was activated by injecting cyano in green. During patch clamp regarding the hippocampus, both strategies elevated LGDL CA1 excitability to levels that are comparable to the wild type. And counterbalancing the PVI hypoexcitability using energy one or using the activation of dread in PVI was sufficient to extinguish the network desynchronization in the hippocampus from agitated animal to levels that are comparable to the wild type. Evans-South 22q11 deletion syndrome is considered to be a neurodevelopmental disorder. We investigated whether the pharmacological or the chemogenetic treatment could be efficient in vivo using adult animals. First, we used in vivo electrophysiological recording the dorsal CA1 of awake mice. And consistently with our in vivo in vitro data, a local field potential in vivo revealed that the theta activity power was lower in LGDL mice than in wild type animals in the theta frequency band and also in the gamma frequency band. The analysis of single units revealed fewer correlated births in LGDL than in their wild type literates. Both NRG1 and injection and the activation of PVI dreads increase the occurrence of neuronal correlation and the power of theta association in awake LGDL mice to levels that are comparable to their control. Last, behavioral testing to the right revealed that LGDL mice displayed hyperlocomotion activity and reduced hippocampus dependent fear memory. Again, the injection of NRG1 and the PVI activation using DREAD increase the contextual response and decrease the locomotion of LGDL to levels that are comparable to the wild type. In conclusion, we demonstrated that increasing the excitability of PVI during adulthood was not only sufficient to restore CA1 network dynamic, but also restored wild-type-like behavior in LGDL mice during adulthood. In line with our observations, an article from Pico Caroni's group showed 2 years later that the manipulation of hippocampal or prefrontal pavalgamine activity during a well-defined time window in late adolescence produced complete and long-lasting rescue of cognitive deficit in the same mouse model of schizophrenia. A week after the publication of my work using LGDL mice in Nature Neuroscience, Carlos Portera Callao, a group, published in Nature Neuroscience 2 a wonderful study that focused on FRM knockout mice that reproduce several aspects of the human fragile X syndrome, a form of the autism spectrum disorder, which is characterized by anxiety, impaired cognitive flexibility, reduced social interaction, and reduced learning and memory. And shortly, they use as a behavioral readout a go-no-go visual discrimination task, which revealed a decreased learning and impaired discrimination in FRM knockout mice with respect to the wild-type animals. And one very, very interesting they did was to test the translational potential of their finding on impaired visual discrimination. And they show that patients suffering from fragile X syndrome exhibit similar visual discrimination deficits than FMR1 knockout mice. And anyways, they investigated whether the perceptual learning deficit observed in mice was caused by abnormal orientation tuning of pyramidal cells using in vivo 2-photon calcium imaging in a V1 cortex layer 2-3. Control of FMR1 knockout mice were presented with 4 sequential presentation of sinusoidal grating drifting in 8 different directions. Even so, they observe no difference in the frequency of visually evoked activity in fMRI mice. They had a significantly lower percentage of orientation selective cells in L2-3 layer. In brief, impaired visual discrimination in fMRI mice correlates with marked deficit in orientation tuning of principal neurons. They hypothesized that abnormal V1 network dynamics could be the result of the dysfunction in parvulbumin interneurons, the most prevalent inhibitory neuron in V1. To test this, they specifically record the calcium activity in PV cells, and PV cells from wild type exhibit a very broad orientation tuning by simply responding to all orientations since they receive local input from a wide range of orientation tuned pyramidal cells. In contrast, PVI from FRM1 mice, knockout mice exhibit a significantly lower frequency of calcium peak triggered by visual stimulus and a significantly lower fraction of stimulus responsive PV cells. Based on those findings, they test whether PV cell activity manipulation will restore their output and improve their performance on the visual discrimination task. So, specific DRED activation induces a significant increase of visually evoked calcium present in PV cells, as seen here, and the fraction of responsive PV cells without affecting the spontaneous activity. And the same chemogenetic activity accelerates learning of the visual task in fMRI mice to levels that are similar to the wild type. In summary, those experimental pieces of evidence using mice model of schizophrenia and autism support the hypothesis according to which PV interneurons, which are powerful network synchronizers, could be a key common factor in neurodevelopmental disorders. However, the link between the causes of those diseases and PVI malfunction remains elusive, even in genetic syndromes such as the 22q11 deletion syndrome, where up to 40 genes are deleted, very few or any, if any, genes are directly connected with PV. The PV interneurons properties. PV interneuron properties could come from the high energy requirements that is associated with their unique morphophysiological properties. And surprisingly, it has been recently shown that the action from parvulbumin interneurons, from locally projecting parvulbumin neurons, were encapsulated with myelin. In some hippocampal subregions, up to 80% of the total myelin content originates from PV interneurons. And myelin is thought to provide metabolic and trophic support for those energetically costly PV cells. PV interneuron-specific myelination processes could be critically involved in neurodevelopmental processes. Interestingly, a large number of myelin-related genes were identified as risk factors for neurodevelopmental disorders, such as NRG1 or NOGO receptor. In addition, alteration in interneuron-specific myelination has been observed using apomorphine-susceptible rat model of schizophrenia. Therefore, I predict that myelinated PV interneurons could be the true missing link between the molecular and the circuit behavioral alteration related to the neurodevelopmental disorders. Continuum. However, the causal relationship between interneuron myelination and neurological properties remains to be clearly established, and actually, this is a part of the research we currently perform in Marseille. And I would like to thank my financial support, Valérie Krepel, and all my colleagues from the Mediterranean Institute of Neurobiology, which is, as you can realize, the worst place to work. I would ask to give a huge thank you to Natalie for having invited me, and of course to you for your attention. If you need to ask me any question, or if you want to join, don't hesitate to send me an electronic mail to this address. And in the meantime, au revoir.